This is the Carvera Air desktop CNC, and with this machine, my workshop finally feels complete. Parts that were previously impossible for me to make can now be made right here at my desk. Well, it's currently on the floor because it weighs a whopping 30 kilos, and I don't trust my cheap desk to not collapse. But anyway, this machine is the more affordable, slimmed down version of the regular Carvera CNC. It just removes the automatic tool changer, the built-in vacuum, and the integrated laser module. Plus, it has a slightly smaller working area now, and a few other changes that I'll show you soon. But considering it's now under half the price, $2,100 USD right now, I'd say these were very smart choices to make, since it's clear Makera are trying to make something with mainstream consumer appeal in a space where there mostly isn't any. While there are a lot of desktop CNC machines out there, they're mostly unbranded DIY style machines without their own software, support, or ecosystem like Makera has delivered here. And included in the box are a heap of accessories, including the instruction manual, spoil boards, stickers, the examples guide, fourth axis module, laser module, a toolkit with a heap of milling bits, PCB fabrication pack, did I mention you can also make PCBs using this? Another accessories box with even more bits and e-stop and some other bits and bobs, then there's the phone or tablet holder, and finally the sample material box that has some assorted aluminium, acrylic, wood, and some other stuff we'll get into later. Anyway, let's make our first project, which means we need to get the app hooked up. I just had to connect to the machine's network, search for it in the controller software, connect the machine to my regular Wi-Fi network, and then I could control the machine from the app, which is the only way to control it. There's no touchscreen or control pad anywhere, and I'm using the desktop version because that's easier for me, but if you prefer, you can get the phone or tablet version and then just mount it on the side. For my first project, I'll be following the guide to mill a little pirate ship from the included epoxy board. And all the GECO files are provided, so I just had to mount the epoxy board securely, click start, and then change the tools when it told me to. There's a lot of mess being made inside the CNC, as you can see, so I just made sure I vacuumed it up periodically. But it does also have a spot where you can attach the vacuum so it collects the waste as it's milling, but I don't have a vacuum that's suitable for that, and none of my projects are so large that it really creates an issue. Anyway, after it did the rough cut, it asked me to change the tool to a chamfering bit, and then it went back in to do all the detail. And here she is, pretty neat for an example project. And there are three more example projects, one for making an LED lamp that includes making a circuit board, plastic base, acrylic diffuser, and aluminium button, one for using the laser engraver, and one for using the fourth axis module to make a figure that I'm going to show you later. But for now, I'm going to dive into the deep end and make my own designs instead. In a previous video, I designed this mold, which I then filled with waste plastic and melted in the oven to make these recycled multi-tools. I didn't manufacture this mold myself, I instead uploaded it to PCBWay's online machining service and they did it for me. But now that I have my own CNC machine, I want to try to make my own mold so that I can recycle some more plastic. This sample aluminium piece was included, so I thought maybe a mold for a coaster could work well given its size. So I designed this infusion, then imported the Carvera profiles for the machine and the standard bits, then I could create a toolpath, export the G-code, upload the G-code to the machine using Carvera controller, and start the job. And here it is, a simple aluminium mold. I sprayed some silicone into it, loaded it with some PLA waste, chucked it into the oven for 15 minutes, squished it down, then loaded some more plastic, chucked it back in, and so on until it was full. Then I compressed it with a tile to make it nice and flat, let it cool down, and popped it out of the mold. From there, I cleaned up the edges a tiny bit until I was left with this. But I want people to know that they're recycled, so I went back into Fusion and generated some G-code to engrave a little recycled icon. Then I taped the coaster back into the mold, auto-leveled it, and used the metal engraving bit to engrave the tiny icon. And with that, my coaster is complete. I'm currently working on another project where I'm making a heap of different molds, so please let me know what you think of this and if you have any other ideas for fun recycling projects. Let's do a quick comparison. This is my mold, and this is the other mold I designed but had manufactured by PCBWay. Obviously, the PCBWay one is far more intricate. They're professionals who know what they're doing with expensive industrial grade machines, and they've even anodized it to give it that nice surface finish. Now, I'm hoping with a bit of practice I can make something almost as good as this myself with the Carvera Air, but until then, there's PCBWay. If you haven't heard of them before, that's okay. They make everything from circuit boards to 3D printed parts, CNC'd parts, and more. And the best part is just how easy it is. I can design and prototype a part at home, then just upload the final file to PCBWay's online service and choose from their huge range of materials and surface finishes. Then they do all the hard work and ship it out when it's done. I've used them a heap in the past to make parts that I simply can't make in my own workshop. Like this clear resin phone case, this chrome plated car badge, and this aluminium 3D printed part. So if you need a hand with manufacturing, check out the link below to save $5 on your first order. Okay, next project. I have this wallet I also made in a previous video, and I want to make a new front panel for it out of acrylic. Maybe it'll look cool, I'm not sure. But anyway, using this sample acrylic piece, I super glued it to some scrap MDF, don't worry, there's a plastic protective layer in between, and then secured it to the CNC. I thought leaving the top protective film on would be okay, but just to be sure, I stopped the machine and then restarted the job. And this is what it looks like after the first pass. It's still connected on one edge, which is a bit weird. I must have done the toolpath wrong, so I started a new job, this time going a tiny bit lower to make sure it was completely cut out. And the last thing I had to do was drill out the screw holes. And here it is, a perfect fit. In the future, I want to make a few more hole wallets as gifts, some out of wood and some out of recycled plastic maybe, but again, I ran out of time for this video, so it'll have to be a future project. Next up, I want to take a look at this thing, the fourth axis module. It's cool because it rotates the material so you can mill from more directions, and it's rare to see these available on consumer level machines at all. But while I was setting it up, I realized the instructions are just really bad. The writing and the diagrams are just not clear at all. It told me to align the module using these pins and then screw it in using these six holes, but there weren't any threaded holes to actually do that, so I was very confused until I realized that these two parts were installed the wrong way around. So I just had to take each side off and put it on the other side, realign it using the pins, then screw it in now that the six holes were aligned properly. Anyway, after that fiasco, I could mount the sample material in the chuck. Oh, and I also drilled out the end so it could be mounted a bit more securely. And now we're ready to go. I was going to hop straight into making my own project, but I got a bit overwhelmed when I selected the fourth axis in Fusion, so I decided I would just start on the sample Nefertiti project for now. Vacuuming up all the waste material was very satisfying for this one. Then I switched to the V-bit tip for it to do the final detail pass. And after cleaning it up, cutting it out with the included mini saw, and giving it a bit of a sand, this is what it looks like. So these were my first projects with the Carvera Air. I was hoping to make a longer video and do some more projects, but I spent the first few weeks of this year being sick and just didn't have the time, sorry. So instead, I'll be releasing some more videos featuring this machine in the next few weeks and months, so please subscribe if you're keen for that. But anyway, I wrote down a few dot points about my overall thoughts about this machine. Number one, Makera seem very confident in this machine, and it's easy to see why. The build is incredibly solid, I didn't run into any issues I couldn't easily fix, and they have a lot of support available. I relied a lot on their YouTube videos for getting started with G-code generation and Fusion, so it's just really nice to see. And the second point is that it's easy to use, but maybe not as easy as you might expect if you're primarily a 3D printing or lasering maker like myself. While the Carvera controller app works, it's definitely not intuitive and it'll take some time to get the hang of it. And whether you decide to use Makera Cam or something else like Fusion, you're going to have to get familiar with toolpath generation, and it's not as straightforward as slicing a model for 3D printing, for example. Point three, the standout feature, and I genuinely mean this, is the guidebook. I'm incredibly impressed with the effort that went into the example projects. They're fantastic, and they walk you through all the different capabilities of the machine. I really appreciated this, and I'm sure a whole lot of other people who are just getting started with CNC machining will as well. And finally, I had a lot of fun. While the projects I made weren't that technically advanced, I enjoyed making them, and I'm really excited to jump in further and make some more advanced projects. So yeah, I had a great first experience with the Carvera Air, and you'll definitely be seeing a lot more of it on the channel. And maybe when you do, it'll have its own proper space instead of being on my floor.